item, we come to balances. This one is an analytical balance. As you can see, I will not be using this one, but this one is analytical balance. Where in the definition of your analytical balance, it is measure the weight of substances which is smaller weight. Usually, as you can see, this can weigh as much as 0.0001 gram. So that is in terms of milligram, actually. So 0.001. 0.0, you have milligram, let's say 1 milligram, that's too small. You could just imagine 1 gram, and then you could divide it 1,000, that is 1 milligram. So this balance here can measure it at that scale. A analytical balance, analysis, a balance used usually for analysis. You don't usually use analytical balance for just a chemical reaction, no. You use analytical balance for analysis because the amount of the material is crucial for analysis. Then this one, you just refer it as an electronic balance because it needs electricity. So this one is electronic balance. As you can see, this can weigh a bigger masses. So if you want to weigh bigger masses, or probably you can use your beaker and then put substances in it while monitoring the mass, then this is the best one because it's already electronic. Then you should giving you output as mass would be faster than balances of this type. This one is a solution balance wherein you can see this bigger balance compared to a this one is a platform balance. As you can see, you have two wings there. So a solution balance, you can usually measure the mass of solutions. So you have beakers probably here, and then you can put your solution or your mixture and then measure its mass. So that's how a solution balance is made, is used. So solution balance is bigger than your, but again, solution balance, you can also use solution electronic balance for that. But if I am the teacher and then my students are not really paying attention, I could make them use the solution balance because electronic balance, as you can see, it has electronics with it. So maybe tampering with solutions and then, of course, mayabong ato, it will destroy the balance. So if I am not there, or I let the student work in the lab, or if I'm going to let you work on your own on the lab, I'd let you use a solution balance rather than an electronic one, so that you would not be, of course, paying because of your carelessness. Because I too myself, when I was in college, I was not too careful. Actually, I have misfortunes also that make me pay, because you have to pay. If ever you broke something in the laboratory, you have to pay it on your own pocket. Why? Because it's not included. Meaning, if you would not pay it on your own, because you're the one, of course, it depends. If you're not the one who destroyed that material or that tool, because it's not included, of course, in your fee. Of course, you have your lab fee, but it is intended for your reagents. That's not intended for your tools and equipments for you to break it. That's why you have to be really careful with things on the inside. Okay? So, the platform balance, this one is actually, we call this dial-o-gram balance, which is actually a platform balance wherein you put weights here on the other side and you put the things that you are measuring on the other side. Of course, with the help of this one. This is more tricky actually in reading masses. But this is these are more rigid than electronic balance. It can last 20 years if being maintained carefully. 20 years up to 30 years. This balance, I guess, has been around for about 20 years already. And I can still attest for its accuracy rather than electronic ones. But anyway, if the electronic balance is a good type of balance, it can last long, of course, without being abused. So, but actually, they can be used with the same purpose. your electronic balance, and then your platform balance, and your solution balance for bigger masses. And for your smaller masses, you can use electronic balances, which are, of course, it differs on its type of or mass.